Concluding my matter. So the blood will conclude my matter. Exodus chapter number 7. We are reading verse number 13 up to 17. And he hardened Pharaoh's heart, and he hearkened not unto them, as the Lord had said. And the Lord said unto Moses, Pharaoh's heart is hardened, he refuses to let the people go. Get thee unto Pharaoh in the morning. Lo, he goeth out unto the water, and thou shalt stand by the river's brink against he come. And the rod which he turned to a serpent, shalt thou take it in thy hand. And thou shalt say unto him, the Lord God of the Hebrews has sent me unto you, saying, let my people go. Are you there? That they may save me in the wilderness. And behold, hitherto thou wouldest not hear. Thus says the Lord, in this thou shalt know that I am the Lord. Behold, I will smite with a rod in my own hand upon the waters which are in the river, and they shall be turned into blood. And I'm seeing here a very powerful story of the children of Israel. The Bible tells me it was prophesied in Genesis chapter number 15 that the seed or the nation of Israel was going to go into slavery for 400 years. And a lot of us, we understand, even through Joseph, when he was sold, we saw Israelites started to increase, they started to multiply, and they were under the rulership of Pharaoh. And they were in slavery. But the prophetic word that was there was that the Israelites will be there for how many years? 400 years. But while they were there, the Bible tells me God raised a man of God by the name of Moses. I want you to follow me as I build this. God will never change anybody, any community, any nation, any situation without raising a vessel he's going to use. So the most important thing you and I need to understand is that you must identify the vessel God is using to bring freedom in your life. Oh, glory to God. So Moses goes now to Pharaoh, and he said, Pharaoh, let God's people go. Listen to this. The matter became hard. Pharaoh hardened his heart. How many of you know that when you're at a point where God must conclude your matter, sometimes things become so bad. Sometimes things become so worse. And you start to say, Lord, where are you? It's like everything is going down. I received a prophetic word, but my life is getting worse and worse. I can imagine here Moses is going to Pharaoh, and he said, hey, let God's people go. And the Pharaoh refused. But listen to me. I'm going to tell you something. The plan of God in whatever situation you are is to rescue you. Somebody say, Lord, rescue me. Somebody say, Lord, rescue me. The plan of God is for him to rescue your life. The challenge that we have, you look for rescue from a human being. So God said, enough is enough. He said, enough is enough. And God said, all right, I'm going to give you 10 plagues. I have spoken to you. You never listened. I'm going to give you 10 signs. You are going to tell your children, and you shall tell your sons' sons, that there is a God in heaven. There are some situations in your lives right now which has refused to let go. But I want you to hear me. Heaven is getting ready before the year comes to an end to fight every power, to fight every yoke. God is getting ready to act on your behalf. I said Jehovah is getting ready, because he's saying enough is enough. You have been waiting for too long. Now I'm arising in my power to change your situation. Somebody shout, I'm ready. And I see Moses speaking to Pharaoh, and Pharaoh is not listening. And he says, number one, I'm going to ask Aaron to put a rod in the Nile, and the Nile water turned into blood. When they went to the river now to get the water to drink, they found the water is blood. As if that was not enough, there was a message in Egypt that there is no water to drink. All the water now has turned into blood. Then all of a sudden, every place they were stepping, there was a sign of frogs. They were jumping everywhere. When Pharaoh was eating the palace, a frog jumped in a plate. He said, it is getting worse. This is not good at all. Maybe it is by me. Mistake. God said, it is okay. I'm not only visiting your water, I'm not only visiting your land with the frogs, but I'm gonna go into your sleep. And he says, I shall bring lice. If you have been in a place where there is lice, you can never sleep at night. If the clothes got lice, you can never sleep at night. When you are sleeping, they are biting you. And the Pharaoh in a palace where everything is supposed to be clean, the bedding's got lice, the chairs got lice. Why is there lice here? You are touching the people you're not supposed to touch. You are holding the people you're not supposed to hold. I come to let somebody know, whoever's held your blessing, they are about to experience the most negative thing in their lives they have ever experienced. Whoever is holding your blessing, whoever says you never finish well, whoever is wishing you bad, whoever wanna see your life coming down, I come to prophesy, heaven is about to open, and my God is about to open heaven, and answer on your behalf is about to rule in your favor. Somebody shout, bah! Don't be afraid of the opposition. And God said, that is not enough. I see lice is not making you to understand. I am going on. Number four, I shall bring flies. Flies, they only come when something is rotten. But there was nothing dead, but there was flies everywhere. And he says, if you don't listen, I'm bringing a sign number five. Sign number five, all the animals are gonna die. And if the animals gonna die, the smell in Egypt, you are not gonna stand it. Lord, why is this all things happening? You are holding people you are not supposed to hold. You are touching people you are not supposed to touch. If you know what is good for you, you must let them go. But Pharaoh was stubborn, and God gave him a number six. Everybody, including the king himself, they had bowels on their bodies. You wake up in the morning, even a person who must treat you has got bowels as well. Ay, 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 ay. Who is gonna treat who? Because the person to treat you is also having bowels. And an enemy can never go scot-free. That's why the Bible says, touch not my anointed ones, and do my prophets no harm. Because you can never go scot-free. And the Pharaoh started to say, something is not okay right now. Maybe I must consider letting them go. But you are still stubborn. Do you know there are situations that refuse to let go? Somebody has held your marriage and they say you never be married. Somebody has held your job and they say you never have a job. Somebody says you die before the year come to an end. They are so stubborn and they don't want to let go. But I am here to let you know that my God is about to demonstrate his power before the year come to an end. Your matter is about to be concluded in the name of the Lord. And when God concludes your matter, it shall be in your favor. Somebody shout, favor. And Pharaoh is sensing all these things. And let me tell you something. There was now a hailstorm. There was a hailstorm in the entire of Egypt. And after the hailstorm, he bring the locust. Everything they have planted, it got eaten. The locusts, they came to harvest on their behalf. Because why? You are keeping what is not good. You are keeping my people. As if they were not listening. And God said, I see Pharaoh is a stubborn person. Let me give him darkness. All the sun was darkened. All the stars were darkened. And the entire place was dark. It was a sign number 9. You don't know what happened in the kingdom of darkness when they try to play with you. I know you are crying and you are depressed. But if you knew what is happening there, you will start to dance. Because you know that the Lord is on your side. And God said, now I'm about to give you a number 10. That's why number 10 is a number of judgment. God himself said, this night I shall pass over Egypt. Now look at this. There is a son who sits next to Pharaoh, waiting when Pharaoh goes, the firstborn must take over the seat. So when God is passing through Egypt, he is killing the firstborn. If he's killing the firstborns, he's destroying the systems of the Egyptians. And he decided to pass through Egypt. And before he could pass, he said, Moses, each family must kill a lamb. Take the blood, put it on the lintel. And when I see the blood, I shall pass over. I want you to help me conclude the matter. It's only the blood that shall conclude this matter. It is only the blood that shall conclude this matter. So I want you to take the blood and put it on the lentils. When I pass through Egypt, when I see the blood, I shall pass over. Because I want to conclude the matter. I want to nullify all your enemies. I want to put them where they belong.